Great news! It looks more and more likely that a MacBook Air 15-inch or a 15-inch MacBook is on its way with this larger MacBook leak that I want to share with you today. I want to tell you all the details about this new 15-inch MacBook with its specs, design, and of course the MacBook Air 15-inch release date and price. But first, a bit of background knowledge of the MacBook Air. The MacBook Air was first announced in 2008 with Steve Jobs showing off the first generation. What made this notebook or laptop or MacBook unique was its form factor, and essentially it kicked off the Ultrabook era for the last 12 years or so. Steve Jobs showed this small form factor by just pulling the MacBook Air out of a brown paper envelope to show how small and thin it really was. The screen size was, and is still today, a 13-inch display. The design wasn't perfect and caused some technical issues, but since then we've had an updated design in 2010 where the MacBook Air really took hold, with a lot of users realizing if you just wanted a MacBook for everyday tasks, then this was the model to buy. Apple introduced an 11-inch model as well at this time. In 2018 though, we got the third generation MacBook Air, what added such features like a Retina display, Touch ID, and an even thinner design, but the 11-inch model was gone. Then in 2020, the Apple M1 Silicon chipset was added to the MacBook Air and was the first MacBook Air to be fanless, and still remains today as the only MacBook to be like this inside the current lineup. But then this year in 2022, we have the new M2 MacBook Air with a brand new design with an M2 chipset and returning features like the MagSafe connector. But there is great news again, as we've been told that a larger 15-inch MacBook is now on its way. One thing that hasn't been 100% confirmed if this will be called the 15-inch MacBook or the 15-inch MacBook Air. But for these videos, until it's 100% confirmed, I'll be calling this the 15-inch MacBook Air. So we've had a new report come in from Min-Chi Kuo, who is claiming a 15-inch MacBook is on its way and that this MacBook will be having the choice between an M2 and an M2 Pro chipset inside. This is super exciting, as many of us have been waiting for a larger baseline MacBook that could potentially be basically a MacBook Air Max, and the price of this MacBook would be cheaper than the 14 and 16-inch MacBook Pros right now, as the lowest one of this costs $2,000. And that's for the baseline 14-inch MacBook Pro. So it's likely that this new MacBook is to bridge that gap between the M2 13-inch MacBook Air that costs at $1,200 and this new MacBook that will cost less than the 2,000 14-inch MacBook Pro. So it'll be somewhere in the middle there. But this also leads me on nicely to say that not all reports and leaks are 100% proof that they will come true with the new MacBook Air. I can only present you what I know and being told and shown. However, if you are still watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is being said about the new MacBook Air anyway. So, WWDC kickstarted the M2 journey, and we're expecting most of the remainder normal M1 devices to get M2 in fall of this year, and also next year in spring of 2023. However, we've had a report saying that the larger MacBook is coming in 2023, where some are claiming production will start at the early end of 2023, ready for the spring event. But others are saying that the M2 MacBook Air Max could be coming in summer, like at WWDC 2023. For the official date of an event of when the MacBook Air will be in our hands, it's a little too early to say at this point, but everything is pointing towards that time of spring or summer next year. We've got to remember that Apple are now updating all their M1 devices to the M2 chipset, and this is a MacBook they'll want to put the same chipset inside, the M2. But in my own personal opinion, at the time of making this video, I think that the MacBook Air might arrive at the spring event in 2023, as Apple soon after will probably be wanting to introduce such chipset as the M2 Pro, the M2 Max, and even the M2 Ultra, and not really talk too much about the M2 chipset, because they'll want that out of the way, and this is targeted towards this MacBook. So then guys, just recently, this channel just got over 400,000 1,000 subscribers, and I did a giveaway for a MacBook Air M1. And if you want to see who the winner was for that MacBook Air 1, check out my other video on my channel where I announced who the winner is. But the great thing is, guys, I am doing another giveaway on this channel, and it is for this. This is for a 14-inch MacBook Pro, and this is with an M1 Pro chipset inside it, the 8-core one with a 14-core GPU and a 512GB hard drive inside. And I'm going to be giving this away now to one lucky subscriber when we get over 450,000 subscribers. And to enter into this international giveaway, all I need you guys to do is put down in the comments below of what Apple gear you're planning to buy or other technology gear in 2022. Put it down in the comments below. And also, guys, if you are brand new here, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because when we get over 450,000 subscribers, I'll be announcing who the winner is of this MacBook Pro, and you won't want to miss out on that video. Now, something else just want to quickly say, sadly still on YouTube, there are lots of scammers and spammers out there, some of them even impersonating myself, telling you to WhatsApp them or to Telegram you or other means as well. Ignore them, or please do report them. It would really, really help, because we don't want scammers and spammers getting their way here on YouTube. Well, guys, with that out of the way, let's return back to the video. So then, let's move on and do a summary of what the MacBook Air Max is going to give us, and also the price. So the new MacBook Air Max, the biggest feature and the biggest change about this MacBook is that it's going to have a 15-inch display. Or specifically, it's going to have that 15.4-inch display. This is the display that we used to have on MacBook Pros, for example, all the way up to when we got the 16-inch MacBook Pro. And this will be an LED Retina display with a resolution of 2880 by 1800. Now, you might have noticed it's not a mini LED display, and also it's not going to be a ProMotion display. Remember, this sits underneath the MacBook Pro, so it's not going to get that better screen inside it. But still, that LED Retina display is still amazing, just like what we have on the normal 13-inch MacBook Pro, and also that new MacBook Air M2. That display is really, really crisp. But for storage, we'll be getting a choice between 256GB all the way up to 2TB of storage. And then inside it, we'll get the choice of that M2 chipset, what will be that 8-core CPU, and all the way up to that 10-core GPU. It's quite likely that that 8-core binned GPU option will also be available for the MacBook Air Max. Then for RAM, you'll have the choice of 8GB, 16GB or 24GB of RAM. It will be an aluminium body design, similar to what we have with like the MacBook Air right now, that new design, but it will obviously be larger, and it'll have a MagSafe connector and two USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports on the side. That new design again will have some new colors. We'll have that new midnight color, but we'll also still be getting that silver, space gray, and gold option. And then we'll probably be getting an actual notch design, and that'll have a center stage webcam, and that will be a 1080p camera. And the battery life on this MacBook Air will probably be up to 22 hours because of that M2 chipset and the larger body frame. It can retain an actual larger battery. The price will start with an 8GB of RAM option with 256GB of storage, would cost $1,299, then 512GB at $1,549, 1TB at $1,899, and then 2TB at $2,249. So that is a spec summary for the new MacBook. But my wishes for this new MacBook is to do with the colors. I am hoping that Apple keep rolling out that midnight black color that we've got on the new M2 MacBook Air, and for it to come on other MacBooks like this one. I'd love to have the ability to buy a midnight silver or gold or space gray MacBook Air Max when it comes out. But those are my thoughts and my current wish for the MacBook Air. However, let me know your thoughts if you agree with this, and also write in the comments below of what your wishes are for the new MacBook large one that's coming out in 2023. Well, guys, on that note, it's time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching this video, please make sure you like it. And at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news reviews and comparisons, please make sure you hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Bye-bye.